May I come in, sir? Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hello, Nisa. How are you?
Sir, I'm fine. Very fine, sir. How
well?
Are you? Yes, sir.
Coming from Bhiwani in the morning or?
Sir, I'm staying with my Masi, sir.
Where is this place?
Sir, Piragadi.
Piragadi. You studied in Miranda House. How is Miranda House?
Sir, it is one of the most prestigious college and the college provided a lot of opportunities, sir.
If you compare this Miranda House with Daulat Ram and which one is better and in what way?
Sir, every college is unique and provide opportunity to a large extent, sir. Especially colleges of Delhi University because of the exposure they have. So Miranda House has a historical legacy and it has developed its own brand, sir. It is performing very well in terms of ranking. And sir, different extracurricular activities also.
Is it still for women or there was some talk of making it co-ed?
Sir, it is still for women, sir.
Still for women.
Yes,
there was
sir.
Talk, no, sir, that is still.
Yes, sir.
Has not happened.
No, sir.
Adventure come nature study camps, where?
Yes, sir. Sir, can I remove the mask? No. Okay, sir. Sir, I have done trekking camps with the Youth Hostel Association of India. Sir, Dalhousie from Dobhi to, Dainkund to Jot in Kulu district from Dobhi to Chandrakhani Pass.
Okay, okay. This legal literacy essays, what type of essays you have written?
Sir, they were organized by Haryana Legal Literacy Authority and I wrote an essay on PCP and DT Act and their awareness. How do we stop the female feticide?
And you got some prize for that?
Yes, I got state level first prize.
Okay, you have put that essay in some magazine or some newspaper also?
No. Sir, they publish in their magazine, sir.
And what on Beti Bachao?
So the movement when it was launched, the scheme when it was launched in 2015, sir, I wrote the essay on Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Again, it was published in their magazine. So I got second position.
So what has been the effect of this program from 15 to now?
Yes, sir. Sir, the child sex ratio has improved to a great extent, sir. For example, in Haryana, it has improved from 880 to 924 now. So these are the observed benefits, but it is one of the largest behavioral movements, sir. It has reached to the grassroots level. The Gram Panchayats have been collaborating. Sir, Gudda Guddi boards have been launched, sir, to register birth of girl child and school education is also being promoted. So,
okay, okay. See now, this morals and ethics in politics. We have opposition. Opposition party, their mandate is very clear what they have to do. And lot of election manifestos are also there, fooling the public. Do you think there are morals and ethics in the politics or it is just one-up game? Everybody wants to be in the power and once they come to power, they feel and do whatever they want.
Sir, I think so. There are ethics and morality in politics as well. And the Gandhian principle will always be relevant because politics without ethics would be disastrous for Indian democracy, sir. So Indian democracy is gradually strengthened. And the ethical principles still uphold that government is accountable to the citizen of the country. So,
where are ethics? Same thing, higher arms, higher arms. If power is given to me, I'll support you, otherwise, I'll withdraw, I'll go to some other party. Everywhere it is happening, Haryana also it is happening. And election manifesto, there'll be so many promises.
Not even 10%. And those promises are at the expense of
who?
Taxpayer money.
Like Punjab also, they I think something for the farmers which was promised in 17, I think at the election time, it is being given now because new elections are coming. So where are the ethics?
Sir, India is one of the greatest democracy and we are gradually improving things. And sir, democracy always comes with its own challenges. But the strength, the deep roots that we have will gradually solve the problem. So regarding anti-defection, sir, we can there are some issues that have to be addressed through amendments in the act. So these issues will be handled, sir, in a transparent and democratic way, and the challenges will be gradually eliminated, sir.
You know, we have panchayats, and there are different bodies are there, committees are there, and there is one committee who looks after access and benefit sharing. Have you heard of that?
Sir, is it related to biodiversity, sir?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about that?
Sir, access and benefit sharing is one of the component of Nagoya Protocol, which talks about sharing of the benefits coming out of natural resources to the indigenous population and the homegrown country, sir.
You know what is Biodiversity Act? What are the objectives?
Yes, sir. Sir, Biodiversity Act... So conservation of biodiversity with the participation of local communities. Sir, genetic resources, the benefits arising out of genetic resources have to be shared with the farmers, sir. So there are certain provisions that benefit the farmers as well. And sir, whenever certain genetic resources
under
have to be...
Under Article 19, we have 5 freedoms.
Yes, sir. Sir, right to freedom of speech and expression. Sir, right to settle in any part of the country. Right to move freely in the country. Sir, right to start any business and commerce activity.
Whether government can take any of these rights?
Sir, they come with certain restrictions. And sir, in when national emergency is imposed, Article 19 automatically gets...
Otherwise, without evidence.
Sir, it has to be with balance with regard to the basic structure, sir. So, government has the power.
Government issues an executive instruction that from this period to this period, and nobody can move freely in state of Haryana. Can they do it?
Yes, sir. So, parliament, if it's a certain constitutional amendment has to be there, so...
Just listen to what I say. Government issues an instruction that in the interest of security and all, nobody in Haryana will move from Panchkula to Assam.
Yes, sir. Government can do so, sir. The constitution provides for restrictions.
Nisha, what's the status of gender empowerment in Haryana right now?
Sir, the sex ratio is gradually improving, sir. The education reach is also improving for girls. Sir, in terms of labor force participation, we have to increase more. So there have been social mindset change after the launch of different schemes. But sir,
can you name some state government schemes for women?
Yes, sir. Sir, Aapki Beti Hamari Beti provides 21,000 cash to the first and second girl child. And sir, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana for financial inclusion of girls. Sir, free education till college education, sir.
How many people from Haryana are representing India in the Olympics?
Sir, I believe it is around 19, sir.
19. Which are the major sports?
Sir, athletics, wrestling, boxing. So this is all I can remember.
Who are the probables who are expected to win a medal?
Sir, I believe everybody are expected to win a medal for
who,
India.
Who are you betting on?
Sir, PV Sindhu, sir. Mary Com.
Okay. Right. So, is it fair to say that the investment environment in Haryana is on a decline?
So, investment?
Environment.
Yes, sir.
In Haryana is on a decline.
No, sir. Ease of doing business ranking has improved in Haryana. It has reached to third
there
rank.
There has been instances of industrial violence happening. You have had policies by the government which talks about privatization or reservation in private jobs. Isn't it impacting the investment environment in Haryana?
So government has recently downgraded the salary level from 50,000 to a lesser level. And so that reservation is for semi-skilled labor. So the mandate provided by the government is that it would provide job opportunities to the indigenous population and may stop the irregular migration. Sir, in the long term, I definitely agree that it could hamper the business environment. So it is not a long-term solution. So, tax incentives can be provided to the industries that have job opportunities to the indigenous population.
What are the three major industries in Haryana?
Sir, it is IT and ITES. Secondly, sir, auto manufacturing, sir. Haryana manufacture around 80% of motorcycles and 60% of cars. So, sir, these and hospitality sector, sir.
How's the automobile industry in Haryana, adopting to electric vehicles?
Sir, Haryana government is giving various incentives to promote electrical vehicles.
Consumption of electrical vehicles or manufacturing of vehicles?
Sir, manufacturing, sir. And in later term, adoption.
Any electric vehicle manufacturing facility in Haryana?
Sir, I don't remember the name of the facility, but it is around Gurgaon Manesar, sir.
Okay. Now, Secretary of State of USA is visiting. Are you aware of this?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what is expected out of this visit?
Sir, the visit primarily aims to address the issues in Afghanistan that we have, because the withdrawal of US will impact our security in Afghanistan, and we have a greater stake there. So negotiation on that aspect are expected out of it, sir.
In your opinion, who is a better ally, USA or Russia? Whom can we trust more?
Sir, do I have to give one, sir?
Yes, you have to choose one. And why?
Sir, in the contemporary time, US is a more reliable partner because of the strategic depth and the relations have gone after the civil nuclear deal.
Okay. Designing.
Yes, sir.
Mehndi has a certain cultural significance. Can you tell me some cultural significance of mehndi?
Sir, mehndi is applied on festivals, sir, in Tej, during Holi, Diwali. So, when we celebrate this festival with zeal, so this provides a spiritual benefit as well. Sir, it is an integral component in marriage ceremony also, which kind of bring a good omen to the married bride, sir. Secondly, sir, it has some medicinal benefit as well. Right from the medieval times, it has cooling effect. So in that aspect also, mehndi is important.
Mehndi is represented or used differently in different religions. Can you throw light on this?
Yes, sir. There are different designs in mehndi. For example, Rajasthani design has more peacock motifs. Then we have Arabic mehndi designing, which is kind of difficult to design, but I try my best to do that, sir.
Okay. Now, what are the materials used for mehndi? Are there different types of mehndi?
Sir, traditionally the mehndi is derived from henna plant, which is Lawsonia inermis. But in recent time, the chemicals such as p-phenylenediamine is also used, which gives a reddish color when it combines with the keratin protein of our skin, sir.
You did BA, right?
Yes, sir.
In history, political science and all that. And from Miranda House.
Yes, sir.
Can you name one ex-CM of Delhi? She was also part of Miranda House, well-known political figure.
Sir, I believe it was Sheila Dikshit, Srimati Sheila Dikshit. Yes, sir.
That's it. Very good. Now, you have Lady Sri Ram also, right?
Yes, sir.
Why is it called Lady Sri Ram? It's a strange name, no? Dolat Ram, fine, Miranda House, okay. But Lady Sri Ram, why this thing?
Sir, I haven't gone through the reason for it, but I believe it is the same founder which was of Sri Ram College. So,
No, that is okay. But why this lady thing? Okay, Sri Ram, you know his name was Sir Sri Ram. Now, do you get the clue? He was given a title of Sir by Britishers.
Sir, I'm not aware about that
so college. Whenever a Sir title gets, the wife is always called the lady. Right? So that's why.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the information.
So instead of naming
sir.
Her, the lady Sri Ram. Anyway. Now, tell me something about monetary policy. What do you understand by monetary policy?
Sir, monetary policy is the policy of RBI to control the money supply in the economy. And the objective of this policy is to control the inflation, which is 4 ± 2%, sir. So this is the objective of the monetary policy. Sir, Sir, the importance of this policy in the Indian economy is to accommodate the fiscal policy, sir. This is the main objective of the policy.
Good. So, now tell me, okay, define monetary policy. Just definition of that.
Sir, monetary policy is the policy to control the money supply in the economy.
You are always linking it to money control. Now you have gold monetization. What is gold monetization?
So, gold monetization is the incentive provided by the government so that the gold in the household sector can be incorporated in the formal economy to increase the resource base of the economy, sir.
So, now define monetary policy. Monetization. What is monetization?
So, monetization is the liquidation of the assets that are with the
giving
government.
Giving money value to any asset.
Yes, sir.
And what is demonetization?
Taking back the
money value.
Yes, sir.
Of any currency or item. Tomorrow, gold can be demonetized. I mean,
yes, sir.
I mean, theoretically. What is gender budgeting?
So, gender budgeting as a concept aims to address and accommodate the budgets that are specifically to address the woman empowerment issues, sir. For example, there are different schemes within the budget that aims to empower women. So, different accounting of that schemes would demarcate how the budgets are allocated specifically for woman empowerment, sir.
Can you name one item in the budget which comes under this?
Sir, I believe, sir, there is a project sir, Dhan Lakshmi, which is about SHG promotion at the village level for women, sir.
Your second option is police service.
Yes, sir.
That's very good. Can you name one or two police officers who are aware of
yes.
the IPS side? Huh? One or two?
Yes, sir.
One.
Sir, my motivation I met her in 10th class, sir, during Republic Day spectacle. She was IPS officer Nazneen Bhaseen, sir.
Okay, tell us something about her. I don't know. She's from Haryana cadre.
Yes, sir. She's from Haryana cadre, sir.
Where is she now? What is she?
Sir, last time when I checked, she was in Mahendragarh cadre district, sir. But I don't know about her present.
Anyway, what happened to your interaction?
Sir, I was in 10th class, so I just had an interaction about what is this service about. So it was just 5 to 10 minutes interaction and the kind of boldness she depicted, sir. And it was, I can see an empowered woman in herself. She was managing the function very well, sir.
But the boldness in front of you. What is the boldness in front of the crowd?
Pardon, sir?
No. Boldness, you said.
Yes, sir.
In front of you, she showed boldness.
No, sir. She was bold as a personality, sir.
As a personality.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you heard of Kiran Bedi?
Yes, sir.
She was not from Haryana.
No, sir.
She was from?
Sir, I don't remember the place.
Punjab, I think. Anyway, so what do you know about her?
So she is presently the Lieutenant Governor in Pondicherry.
Oh, she's still there.
Sir, I'm
no,
sorry.
No, don't say that. IPL. We are all discussing about IPL. Huh? She is no more Lieutenant. She gave up the reshuffle, whatever. Okay, we have a department called Ayush. What is this department doing? What is the full form of Ayush? Can you tell me?
Sir, it is about the traditional medicine that we have.
What is
sir, Ayurveda, Yoga, Sir, Siddha,
And you for?
Sir, Yunani, sir. One is about, sir, I don't remember the last one, sir, H.
What is this Siddha thing?
Sir,
what is Siddha?
Sir, Siddha is a community as well. So
community?
Yes, sir.
Where? Which part of India?
Sir, in Gujarat and Karnataka especially.
Gujarat and Karnataka. Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Hi, Nisha. Nisha, I just read, it is, you also spoke about Beti Bachao. Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao. And you said it's one of the biggest and the most successful behavioral campaign. So, can you name some more campaigns like this which have happened in the past? Not Beti Bachao, behavioral campaigns.
Sir, ma'am, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has been one of the major behavioral movement in terms of cleanliness drive, ma'am. So that has also been a very successful initiative.
Now, in terms of education, which article of Indian Constitution talks about right to education to all people irrespective of caste, gender or creed?
I think it is article, it is one of the fundamental duty as well, and article 45 talks about it.
Yeah, and what is the importance of it?
Ma'am, the importance of it is that it provides a directive to the government that whenever resources are available that you provide free education till, now it is from 6 to 14 years and primarily at the secondary level education. So that directive would increase the education initiatives by government to larger extent, ma'am.
So Haryana had recently announced something in the direction of women empowerment, Haryana government. So could you tell what exactly they have announced, which leads to, it leads to women empowerment. So any announcements by Haryana government on some reservations?
Ma'am, there are different initiatives. For example, Mission Chahak is there to provide semi-skilled job opportunities to the domestic help workers. Then free.
In regards to elections or anything?
Ma'am, there are
reservation in some elections.
Ma'am, there are 33% reservation in panchayati and municipal board elections. Ma'am, that is all I know about it.
33%.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Fine. So it's increased recently. But do you think that it would help, and it somewhere connects with the empowerment of women, and how do you think that it will help, it will be of help?
Ma'am, reservation, as you said that it has increased, so 33% reservation has provided many initiatives that that gender empowerment at the local level has increased, ma'am. For example, that is also reflected in the Khap panchayats that are there. For example, Bibipur Khaps has women elected representatives, and they are promoting women education. And further, ma'am, dowry is also disfavored through these panchayats. So, ma'am, whenever women representatives are there, so more visibility of women at the local level happens, and that kind of provides incentives to the local population that they need to invest in their girl child as well, ma'am.
So you just talked about dowry. So what is the Dowry Prohibition Act 1961?
Ma'am,
do you think that it is successful or it has failed?
Ma'am, Dowry Prohibition Act prohibits the dowry and it makes it a criminal offense. Further, ma'am, the act has been successful. However, the mindset change at the family and the community level is missing. So legal provisions are well in their place, ma'am. So we need to strengthen the community awareness that you have to be resistant against dowry at the family and the community level, ma'am.
So you think that this has helped in bringing down the cases of dowry?
Yes, ma'am, it has helped.
Okay. And how do you think that we can get rid of this problem? Because apart from, you know, whatever provision we have or whatever the act is passed, what other steps can be taken to address this problem?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the recent cases in Kerala has shown that even if the state has done very well in education front, the dowry deaths are still there. So, ma'am, I believe to address this issue, more economic independence to the woman has to be there. For example, ma'am, in Haryana, they participate in agriculture, but there is no land resource in their name. So land resource is a very empowering resource that can they have. Further, ma'am, the economic independence can also be come through SHG participation. So education, health and economic opportunities are something that we have to work upon, ma'am.
What is the recent Supreme Court judgment on migrant workers?
Ma'am, the judgment directed the government that they need to collate the data on migrant workers. So it is about providing a database to migrant workers and the policy initiatives that the government would take to empower them.
And what is the significance of this order?
Ma'am, it has provided a incentive to the government and a directive to the government. However, there are some debates that certain executive decisions must be kept out of judiciary. But ma'am, judiciary has been the harbinger of rights of people. So it is seen as both ways, ma'am.
What is this one nation, one ration card?
Ma'am, one nation, one ration card aims to increase the availability of ration to the migrant workers, to address the administrative issues that sometimes they're not able to get their ration in different states when they move. So it is about integrating the data across states so that the food security of those migrant workers is addressed.
What led to this, that, you know, we had to come out with this one nation, one ration card?
Ma'am, there are some structural differences in terms of availability of ration in different states. So that integration of data did not happen. So that was the primary reason, ma'am.
Recently, what has happened which has prompted the government to take up this?
The pandemic has been provided a push to the government so that they need to accelerate on this. Ma'am, the job loss, and due to which they are not able to earn their livelihood, and that has impacted their food security, ma'am. The people have moved back to their cities. So there has been structural and a huge shift in terms of migration, ma'am. So that kind of provided us the more push that a more integrated database base has to be there.
Okay. Your interview is over.